was telling these guys, when I want anything technical, these are the two I go to, so they can figure it out for me. So, go ahead, Chip.
Well, since you guys are doing movies with the teen scene, we thought it'd be good to have, you know, a little bit about story creation, the actual process of recording, and then obviously, once you're done, you need to have a way to get your video onto YouTube.
Yes, YouTube.
So, one of the programs I use at City Hall is Adobe Premiere Elements. Something that they had before I got there to do commission meetings, so we can get them on to TigerNet. So it's a good program. It's a cut back from what you've got, but with the same features, you'll see the same interfaces. Actually, the Pro has some more interface features to it that you'll have to get used to because there's a preview pane and the work pane. Your timeline at the bottom, and then some other things on the side you can add to that and make a real cluster of stuff. But in the short and skinny of it, first thing you need to do is, once you have your videos made, whether you tried to shoot the entire movie from start to finish in one shot or in a couple takes, you'll end up with several different clips. What you need to do, obviously, is first get them into the computer. So I got my flash drive and I've already imported my videos, but the first thing you're going to do when you open up Elements is it'll ask you where you want to go. It usually starts at this eLife home screen, and it gives you some options for some other tutorials that you can go visit from some filmmakers and even Adobe itself for how to use a lot of features. Expert mode is where I go to start with. Usually in the version I have, it's the only mode there is. So it's as easy as clicking the Add Your Media. It'll ask you what you want to do. Since you're copying from a flash drive or possibly even a camera that's hooked up, it has options to try and find your camera and pull the videos in. But we'll go with the files and folders. Like I said, I've imported mine. It may ask on your first import, depending on the video file type, whether it's an AVI and a QuickTime video, it'll ask you to use the video importer because it's the way it is. Once you get your videos in, they come here into Project Assets. So these are all your video clips that you have. Depending on your videos, you may have 2, you may have 10, you may have 20. So you grab each one of your videos, and you bring them down here into the timeline. And you can place them in any order you want. Obviously, you're going to put it in the order that you want to run your video. And each one snaps into place. You can move them around however you want. Some of the other things you can do with these videos when you put them in, say you want, a quick one is, say you want something to go in slow motion. So easy, so you grab the video, and you'll see on this corner here, on the edge of the video, gives me an option to drag. It's going to give me an option to either push or pull my video clip. If I pull it out, it's going to slow the video down so that it runs it in slow motion, or if I compress it, it's going to speed it up to however fast I pressed it up to. So I can run it at 100%, which is normal speed, 200, double time, quadruple, and also run it in reverse. So if, say, you've got somebody running down a hall, and you want to use an effect where you're pulling it backward, and you right-click on the video and go to time stretch and hit reverse speed, and it'll actually play the video in reverse. So first, I've got this video of Jake when we were on a trip a few years ago. Hopefully he doesn't mind me showing this, but he's got a cardboard sled and he's sliding down a sand dune. And to undo it, it's just as simple as going back into that time stretch and reverse, kind of clicking that reverse audio. I just changed it in that video in that time stretch also, so that it runs at 200%. Now, in the timeline here, it will continue to play through all your videos. So if you have gaps in your video, be aware that it'll continue to play even if there's nothing there. It'll just show your end clip until the next one starts. So if you've got some open space, check that unless you're going to use a transition between your videos or between your scenes. So let's say, on top now, after we've done those few things, say you've got a video clip that you've got where you've got your marker, you accidentally got your marker and you started your video too soon, put 3 or 4 seconds in front that you really don't need. We can go in with our time, marker here, our time point, we can grab what we want.
There it is.
In here, along the timeline here, wherever. wherever your current funding is, a little scissors here. With that, you can cut and trim what you need taken out. So if you get, like I said, if you get 3 or 4 seconds ahead of where your scene actually starts, you can clip that out and delete it. You can do that front and back and as many times as you want, or if you've got two scenes together that are back to back, and you've got some time, if you plan to pad some time in between them, you can split the scene so that you can move them wherever you need to move them to. So I can take this in the middle here, clip it, and I can move my second scene where I need it, and keep the rest of it where that's where it was supposed to be. I can move that around, snap everything together, which is going to make no sense. So it's just random for me. We got that. And the camera I used this morning was a little handy cam kind of thing, so pardon the jitter in it. I'm just wandering around City Hall. So, and then is one of the first things you'll have in there, obviously, is your title. So we can start there and do a new text. And there's 3 different styles of credit you can do. If you can do a sprawl, which is across the screen, your camera roll, which is traditional kind of credit style where it's rolling up the screen, or you can just do a static one over the top. And it gives you, again, here you've got your title and all your text. It walks you through a lot of this stuff. So like I said, it'll hold your hand if you have questions or you're not sure what it is. I will say one thing, though, about if you start getting into where you want to do some more intensive things and some video effects, if you use these computers and are actually any computer, be careful. If you accidentally hit a wrong transition, it'll show you the transition on the side. Sometimes the computer doesn't like it too much and it'll chew away at that for a few minutes before you can do anything else. So save often in case you have to control or delete and close down. It does happen once in a while. Audio, each video clip obviously is going to have its own audio track. When you're playing back, you can listen for highs and low spots. You can adjust those, or you can do a normalize, where it finds the lowest of the low and the highest of the high, and it calculates the midpoint between that, and it will adjust all the audio to kind of fit into that. So if you get somebody that's really close to the camera speaking, somebody further away, it's going to pick this person up better than that. So you can use that to kind of bring that person in the background up a little bit more. You can also take out audio completely and replace it. So you grab an individual clip, you can right click on it and do delete audio. And if you have some dubbed audio that you want to use, or move or song, you can throw those in there. You can also do narrative sounds if you're doing more of a documentary style video, or soundtrack audios in the background, so you can have more of that Hollywood feel where you've got like an action scene and you got the dramatic music in the background. And actually Adobe has some audio built into it. It has some functions that it runs in the background when it puts it in, so that it'll run the video, the audio clip to match your scene clip. So if you've got a short scene, it'll speed up or cut out some of that music so that it gets more or less of what you're wanting it to do. feature in case you do need something you don't want. Yes, honestly, I mean, that's the short and skinny of the easy way, the easy part of any of it. When you're done with your video clips and you've got your movie ready, or you preview it one time, preview it a couple of times, just make sure everything's how you want it. Then when you're ready, you can do a share and publish, and we can send it right up to YouTube. Just log in with your account. It'll render everything out, and it'll push it up automatically. So, again, it's, you know, like I said, that's the short and skinny of basic video creation for it. There's a lot of features in it. Kind of play around with it. Even before you get to your actual video, you've got, you know, your phone. Grab some video on that, just for something to play with. You can do a lot of, like I said, you can do a lot of things with it. You can do black and you can turn anything into black and white. You can black and white certain features. If you've done anything with a green screen, a blue screen, this has the ability to find that screen, and you can replace video behind you. You can also do chroma key, where you actually pick a color and it'll blank out and put in front where that color is, you know, a video inlay that you choose. So if you got several options, if you're thinking you want to add some scenery in the background that we don't have around here. Save back to your flash drives. We don't want anybody to accidentally lose their work, because that would be bad. Yeah. You got any questions, anything you'd like to know that I might not have covered as a basic? I know iPad has some apps. I know Apple has some apps that you can do some video editing with. There's several other applications. Apple makes a couple for its built-ins. Windows has DVD Maker, which is more of a basic, cut it, rip it, you're done. Adobe Pro, After Effects, believe is another one. Adobe has several product offerings, and there's other commercial ones available. There's some free ones too that they'll get the job done, but they don't have a lot of the extras. But with the iPad, I think if you got your video on the cloud, you can pull it down and bring it into here to use it too.
You don't want to do that, Brian?
No.
Pardon? No, we can help you.
You said Adobe has like built-in music?
It does. If you go into, actually just right down here at the bottom, there's an audio for soundtracks, there's audio for sound effects. So if you've got a creaking door, you want some thunder and lightning, sounds of a rainstorm, you know, there's different groupings and different audios in those groupings, as well as some sounds, some free soundtracks. You can find some places that you can get your own, or try to get, you know, royalty free stuff. You usually have to pay a one-time fee on the majority of those. Adobe does have a site of its own where you can get royalty free downloads for audio video transitions that are, you know, a little bit more. That have a little bit more than the canned ones that are part of the program. Sometimes they'll have like a, you know, sign up now, you get 10 free, or pay for them. I don't know what the cost is. I think they they range from relatively inexpensive to pretty expensive. But like I said, it does have a lot of them in here. You have musical scores, and you do ambient, atmosphere. Let's see what happens when you do this. It doesn't install them automatically. It has to download them off the internet from Adobe's site. We have a pretty good connection so that people can take them all to get whatever. And once it's downloaded, then it's in there and it'll load faster.
You're so impressed with how it turned out. I think it would work. And we suffered through it. Thanks, Mary. That's called child labor.
Yeah.
Called child labor, Mary. I learned a lot. It was fun, though.
It was pretty simple.
It was.
Which one was that?
When you have them build the computers. To renew a teacher's certificate, you have to take classes every 5 or 6 years, but I always took the tech classes because they were fun. I mean, you didn't sit and get lectured at, you gotta play and stuff.
There's this thing called GEMS from SDSU, and they get a bunch of girls to come into the just come to the campus, and then you learn about how different aspects like forensics and robotics. A bunch of other stuff.
Guys went last year.
Yeah, we've been going for 3 years, but this year we didn't go because we kind of know what we want to do now. That's why we kind of went. But it used to be a lot of fun. Like, we did a lot of programming. We built a little robot, and then we went on the computer and we programmed it into like Tango or whatever. And just kick around something, but it was so cool. It was a lot of fun.
I think this light bulb
app. So cool.
It does take a minute to get it downloaded, and it's got a couple of things that it does after it gets downloaded, but like I said, after you've used it, it'll come in quicker. And you can adjust. Pull it back to adjust to match everything, because it's either going to be, more than likely, it's going to be shorter or longer than what your clip is or your scene is. By scene for different video. You can pull it and make it all match. Audio gain, that's where you can pump the volume up as much as you want. Be careful with that though, because you will get distortion out of it. If you get it too high, you'll get a lot of hiss from where the mic would be. But the normalize feature is where, like I said, it brings that high and low and kind of evens everything out. Adobe has a lot of free tools for Elements and Element Pro, as well as Atomic Learning has videos for some different, as far as tutorials on how to make video and how to use the Adobe softwares.
That was the databases I gave you on Atomic Learning. Remember I gave you a thing? We have that. That's, yeah.
Oh, the website?
Through the library.
Oh.
The library databases. Atomic Learning.
So there you go. Now you should have everything you need to make a movie.
Cool. These computers will be out here.
Yep, and these are here for your use. They aren't tied into the PC Res software, so I think Mary will give you guys a couple hours to work on them when you're here if you need, or even more time if you need it.
So no reservation.
No, you don't need a reservation.
But you have to work on your
prompt. Yeah, you gotta, yeah.
And if you're going to use sound, bring earbuds. Because I only want to listen to a song maybe once and then I'm done. And my desk is right there.
Play classical music.
Yeah. I gotta pick a song of my favorites. Have you started on yours at all? Do you have a partner? Or you can do it on your own? Who's your partner?
Jackson.
Okay. Oh, okay. I think he was our mystery dancer, wasn't it? Jackson Forrest. Is that the Forrest that owns PB, or not PB, Peep? What, Office Peep? He works there, his dad. He was the one who put on.